welcome back to Afro Beats Live. Now, do not forget to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and our website, AfroBeatLive.net. Now, welcome back. Now, we have here with us one of the biggest, the most talented, the cutest, if I may say, okay, African artist in the building, all the way from Nigeria.
Hold on. I don't even know how to. Before you ever introduce this guy, let me say one or two things about this guy.
Go for it. Yeah? Go for it.
Some things where I know personally. He's a Nigerian hip hop recording artist and actor.
Boom.
He rose to fame after releasing Oleku, one of the Nigerian most remixed of all time.
Ice Prince, you understand?
He won 2009 Hennessy Artist Street Club Tour.
His achievement
also include one BET Award, one Ghana Music Award, three Headies Award, two Nigerian Entertainment Award, and two Channel All Music Award. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up to my homeboy.
What up? It feels so good to be here, man. Like, for real. You guys have me blushing before the interview. I just want me to be honest now.
How are you feeling today?
I feel good, man. I mean, like, it's a blessing to be alive. It's a blessing to have teeth. I was telling you about it. Thank God for your teeth, because you need your teeth to eat, right? I mean, it feels good to be alive. It feels good to, I mean, be out here with you guys and rock it on Afrobeat Live.
Thank you. How was your flight? How was everything? How's it been so far?
My flight was not too stressful. Yeah.
Okay.
It's easy.
All right. So thank you for joining us in the house. Now we have a few questions. So you need to promise to keep it real.
I'm gonna keep it real.
Like 100%.
All the way. 100%. I promise you that. That's tight. You know me, man.
What up, Ice?
Yeah. What's up?
What's good, man?
I'm good.
Homeboy to homeboy. What's in the album? Real recognize. People they talk language with anybody on that. On the streets, and I saw.
No, on the real though, we actually like literally did for streets.
We did.
You know, we're on the grind still. It's been 6 years doing this music pretty actively. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because Ole Cool dropped in 2010, and I always define that as the beginning of my career.
Yes.
So I would say I'm 6 years deep in the game. But yeah, same.
That's what's up. Now, one thing I want you to understand, anytime we do an interview down here, we like it to be, we want our guests to be as comfortable as possible.
I'm comfortable, man.
You know,
see,
we
the
want
cup.
You to be relaxed.
I'm comfortable.
I'm going to throw some questions. We're going to shake you smooth.
My life is transparent already, so I don't get anything to hide. Like, I'm going to be honest with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Speaking of that.
Yeah.
Now. Why did you start music? Like, what was it that just, is it something that, you know, you were born with, or was it something you were just like, you know, what was it?
I wouldn't say I was born with it, but I used to have an uncle that was a local musician, and just when I was growing up, he used to play like traditional music, and he was quite famous doing that. I used to always be around him rehearsing with his band, you know what I mean? When I say band, I'm not talking about trumpets and flutes and guitars, I'm talking about some xylophones, some local stuff. So I grew up around that sort of sound, you know, like following my uncle and stuff. And when I got into secondary school, I used to always perform at social nights. You know, like every social night in school, I would mime a song from Tupac or from Heavy D back in the day and stuff like that. So I got famous from performing at social nights in different secondary schools around me. Mm. You know what I mean? And normally you get famous, it's sweet. I took it to the studio. I started, instead of perform like miming the songs from these guys, I would take their beats and try to put my own lyrics on it. You know, so gradually I started getting into studio.
To be successful in this entertainment is
I know it's smart.
I mean, it comes with a lot of things, a lot of challenges. Mm-hmm. It comes with a lot of challenges, and one thing I always try to get people to understand, if you are surviving in this business, it'll be just only your own effort to follow your lesson of
trust.
Because
trust
some of the things you face, challenges wise,
yeah,
financial,
yeah. Trust me.
Physically.
Trust me.
Spiritually
from
everything.
Everywhere.
So if you happen to survive,
it's bigger than talent. It's bigger than talent.
And I bet sometimes you even think like, out of all the people I grew up with, why me? Why did God choose
to
stand up?
Yes. I have those moments sometimes. I cry sometimes, bro.
I feel
on some real stuff.
That's real.
On some real, real, real stuff. I look in the mirror sometimes and I cry.
You guys.
Yeah, no, for real.
No, it's real, man. It's real.
Oh, for real, man. I come from a city called Jos. Like, you need to take a trip to Jos to know where I'm from. I'm not. Okay, if I was from Lagos is kind of like posh, you know what I mean? Lagos is, you know, very modern, you know what I'm saying? Compared to Jos. I'm not saying Jos is not modern, you know what I mean? Like, my city is still fresh.
Yeah.
But, you know, we're on the other side.
Right.
So to come out from that place and
from the north
to be sitting out in DC with you guys, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's more than a blessing. Sometimes when you look in the mirror,
you
ask yourself those questions, like, why was me out of everybody that I even started rapping with? You feel me?
So aside from you, like, what other A-list, like, musicians do you admire?
A lot. This is a long list, but every time I'm asked this question, I just use Two Face as a point of contact to give a shout out to all the people that I look up to. You know what I mean? Like, Two Face is a role model in my eye, and of course MI, who brought me up in the game. You know, M taught me how to do almost everything I know how to do musically today. So
I feel it.
That's
I always look up to those people.
Let me ask you this: you play any instrument?
I play the drums a little bit. Not professionally. I don't play on stage.
Not jazz.
I don't play on stage, but you know, give me a drum and I can, you know, if you give you Makosa, if you give you Kunto, if you give you.
let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Since you're so busy, you travel so much
from
all over the place. I experienced in New York today, and Australia tomorrow, and Canada.
Yeah.
When do you get time to get in the studio and record?
I always make sure I have a studio around me. You know what I mean? I always carry a studio with me. Some, I always, you know, travel with studio when I'm going to a city that I don't really know people that much.
Okay.
If not, if I'm going to a city where I know people, there's already a studio there. Like, I'm in DC, I have studios.
Everywhere.
Right. Not my personal studio, but there's so many producers that I work with out here too.
Why you never call my own studio?
I need to rock with you, for real.
Why not? You know one thing? Let me tell you something. I've only seen that experience from afar. And I've always been like, he have this kind of mindset. He put himself at.
When I wish y'all could see him right now.
What?
Right?
No. He bring this positive vibe. I've never seen him actually being negative. And that's one thing I like about him. That's one thing I respect and I like about him.
Right.
Anything he say, you know, like earlier.
Coming from Big Dog, I appreciate it.
I was about to chow. Honestly. And the first thing he said was, hey, we have to pray.
Exactly,
yeah.
And it's
real.
Yo, that's real.
It's real. I've seen.
I don't know what I'm going to eat with you guys again. You know?
It's real because I've seen, you know, musicians and actors and actresses coming from Nigeria to this country and to this state, and I can tell you that you are one of the most humble people I have met.
Wow.
For you, like when I met you, like earlier
Stop.
Like when I met you earlier,
can we get into your questions?
Check this out. Some of the questions that some of your fans threw to us online that they want to know.
Yeah.
What has been your best memory on stage?
My best memory on stage?
And where?
That's a very good question.
Ever.
My best memory on stage till today will still be Hackney Festival.
Mm-hmm.
The BBC Hackney Festival. About 2 years ago.
Okay.
And they had me from Africa and Debanj from Africa. It was just the two of us and it was like a very, very big global stage. Like, I was on stage, we shared stage with like from Jay-Z. Mm. I always say from Jay-Z down. Think about anybody else that you would think like from Jay-Z down. And they had me and Debanj perform from the Afrobeat side and that was really, really monumental in my career.
That's love right there.
Yeah,
and also, let's do the opposite. What has been your worst memory on stage? You don't fall off stage, you don't stumble, the microphone don't seize.
My pants got ripped off.
Oh! Did it get ripped off?
But it was so much energy though. It wasn't like it was fake pants or whatever, but...
Hold on, but
it was in Sierra Leone, bro. In Sierra Leone. It was really, really bad, but from the back of the trouser, the top, like where the from where the belt starts, all the way down to where the zip starts.
No.
Like,
that's
it was
crazy.
Not bad. Like, so I had to put on a towel throughout that performance.
That's crazy.
It was a stadium, bro. Let me say that for one Prado. It was like.
But the show must still continue.
Of course it has.
That's what I'm saying.
I put on a towel for my body now and I consume it. It's still one of my favorite shows till today. Wow. Big up Sierra Leone, man, and all my Sierra Leonean fans.
Okay. Yeah. How do you balance your music life, your business life, and your family? You have a son, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I do have a son.
How is he doing? He just had his birthday.
Yeah,
right?
he's four now.
Happy birthday!
Yes, shout out to my boy, man. Thank you.
His name Jamal.
Jamal, Zamani.
Okay.
Just a Jay-Z story.
So how do you balance that with traveling and family?
To be honest, I'm really blessed to have a lot of, you know, good people around me and my team, the people that, you know, I do work with, you know what I mean? I focus on the music most times. Like with the business, for example, mm-hmm. I have a business manager called Toby Sonny Daniels that is, in my book, the best business manager any artist can ever have. You know what I mean? You're good if you have Toby handling your money, you feel me?
Okay.
And so yeah, with the business part, I don't really focus that much on it. If I need to attend a meeting, or if I need to sign a document, or if I need to, I'll be there for sure. But
yeah,
you know, I leave that to other people to handle, which is Toby. I handle the music. With family, that's kind of tough because they don't see me or have me around them as much as they should, but God has been faithful.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's love, man.
Speaking of personal life as well, yeah. We do have one thing in common.
My
birthday is October 23rd.
Oh, it's coming.
Yes, we're the best.
I'm an October baby too.
October
11th.
Okay.
Shout out to all the Libras.
Scorpio for life. Okay, so now on that note.
You're special, by the way.
Thank you.
Shout out.
I know, I like to think I am. Okay, so anyway, so we're October babies. Now, Speaking of personal life, do you have a leading lady in your life you need to
know? A leading lady.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
By that you mean a girlfriend, right?
Of course.
Yeah, I do have a girlfriend.
That's what's up, man.
Okay, how's that going?
I thought you knew that already.
I mean, we had to hear it from you. You know what I'm saying? There have been things being, you know, settled.
Like I said earlier, my life is so transparent. Like I can't even hide anything anymore, you know?
Right.
Yeah, shit.
Okay, sounds good. And
she's
like
from
how?
Ghana.
Nice.
Shout out to Ghana.
She's hot.
She is. Yeah, she's awesome.
Hey, Ice, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
If you had to give an advice to the up and comers, which advice would you give to
them? It'll be. I always say this, man. I always have one message to this, you know, to anybody who's looking up to Ice Prince or whatever.
Okay.
Use me as an example.
Okay.
You feel me? Like I said earlier, I came from literally nothing, you know, pardon my sentence. But yeah, I came from that to where I'm at right now. So if I could do it with all of my, you know, misfortunes or everything that happened in my life, I didn't graduate from university. I didn't have the opportunity to. I don't speak the best English, I don't believe I'm good looking, I look down on myself sometimes, you know what I mean, but if I'm able to get there with all of these imperfections, then it's not impossible for anybody, you know what I mean, so that's my message all the time, use me as an example, I did it,
okay.
It's not impossible, you can do it too, you know, even more.
That's for sure. Let's clarify this next question. I want everybody on the everybody online, you know, they will be watching this.
Yeah.
I want them to clarify this.
Yeah.
We started off with was it Echo Mark?
Yeah. Echo Mark Squad. Yeah. That was my first group.
Okay. Then you and your crew, you guys decided to come up with Loopy crew.
Nah, Loopy was MI's birth. That was MI's baby. MI started that.
Okay.
Nah,
the first official record label was what, Chalk?
Chocolate City, yeah, that's the first record.
Now, what's the status? What's the situation with Chocolate?
I'm the vice president right now.
Okay, so everything's still good. Everything's
good. Yeah, everything's good.
Everything's good.
I said I'm the vice president.
You don't be counseling the vice president.
No, I mean, like, everything's all good. We're good. 100%. Like, that's my family. And you know, family's always family. Mm-hmm. I have a baby project I'm just starting called Super Cool Cat.
Okay.
And I know that's kind of confusing. When people see me say Super Cool Cat, they always think, oh, Ice is Lady Chocolate City.
Super cool cat. I like that. SCC.
Yeah, man, that's my baby.
Make the camera see her. Make it see her. SCC. I like that.
It's just a collection of different, you know, creatives from music to, you know, behind the scenes of music. I have producers that are signed to Super Cool Cat. I have video directors. I have graphic artists. We have DJs. You know, just a bunch of creatives. It's not a record label that would say, okay, I'm signing this artist and signing that artist. No, it's just a click.
I like that. I like that. Well, keep doing what you're doing, bro.
Thank you, man.
What's the last project? What's the last single that you got?
The last single, I've been dropping songs recently on my SoundCloud, like anyhow, because I feel like I need a lot of material out there. But the last record I dropped was Seasons on my SoundCloud, so it's for my rap fans. It's a hip-hop one called Seasons, and I said a lot of stuff from inside on that one. You should check it out. Fabster, you got that? You should download Seasons.
We're going to make sure to play it.
Yeah, you should. Let me tell you what songs to get on. Get on Seasons and get on Feelings.
Okay.
Yeah, cool. Get on those two songs.
How did you come up with that boss post?
Boss
post? You're going to teach me how to do that. Every time I band, it's like,
when I put out the song, yeah, mm-hmm. I just felt like people might confuse mm-hmm. my message in the song, and it might come off sounding as cocky,
okay.
Because the word itself, boss, is a cocky word, let's be honest. Yeah, so if I put out a song,
it means you're in control now.
Yes,
you're running things.
I didn't want the record to come out and make me look like I was calling myself something. You feel me? So I had to take this, that's the streets pose right now. Mm-hmm. Real bosses don't go down like that, you know what I mean? So I actually make the average one.
Well, you don't think they chop them, whatever. They think chop them.
I make them bend down. But I just wanted something that the streets could relate to, you know. And if you're on the streets, whether you're a vulcanizer or a plumber, you're a boss. I have cab drivers in Lagos that are bosses. Like, I have a cab driver that I know. He's a cab driver. He fixes ACs. He mm-hmm. fixes cars. He does haircuts for people. He does a whole bunch of stuff, and he makes so much money from this.
See, one step.
He's actually a boss on the streets in Ubudu. Okay. So
basically, it's about being a boss.
It's about owning. It's about owning yourself. It's about owning life and owning your surroundings and just making the best out of everything that you can put your hand on.
Now you know that you're not just gonna come up here and I'm gonna let you go just like that.
Yeah, I'm gonna freestyle.
I want to hear something. And you know which line you always catch me every time. That part where you say something like, I just pretend like I'm laid back, you know. Follow me to Festac.
Everything I do, I'm a legend, I be like Festac. Fucking in my
head. Oh boy, that line, boss. Nice one.
Shout out to Techno, man. Techno, laced that beat in a very short period of time. Few hours. It wasn't up to like two. It wasn't even up to 2 hours.
Right.
And techno laid his whole beat. I came in just. I was like, damn, man.
That boy's talented.
I didn't even want to go anywhere. Fucking in my head. Turn up.
So real quick, you just gotta play a quick game with us before we let you go.
Hold on. Let me jump in real quick because I have a question I need to ask you.
What's up?
Talking about you being the boss and everything.
Yeah.
There are some rumors on the street that Millie, who was signed to Chocolate City, did leave the group. What's that about?
To be honest with you, I'm hearing that too, the same way you're hearing it online and stuff.
I mean, but you're the boss. You gotta...
No, I am the boss, but see, Millie is a boss too. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's been on the road. He just came back from South Africa. I know too. He just went back to Nigeria from South Africa. He's been on the road. I haven't spoken to him or any of his manager in a little bit. I've been on the road myself. And this news I heard... about 2 days ago.
Okay.
You know,
because I went to
it's not in my email yet. I didn't hear anything from family that there's a problem in the family. So I just let it fly with the birds.
Because I thought it was kind of strange because I even went to his page and he took out Chocolate City and everything from his
bio.
Yeah. Like, I was like, okay, what's going on? I haven't heard a press release or anything.
It's
so.
About to. What? Okay.
Did I just break some news to you?
Yes. You really did. I need to call Millie right now.
So let's get this game on the road.
Oh boy.
But this game, no be questions, Abi.
No be questions. Okay, so it's called.
Don't embarrass me.
It's very fun. It's very quick. Okay, so it's called rapid response. Okay. So we're gonna say a word, and the first thing that pops into your mind.
Okay. Are we all gonna do this game? Or it's just me?
Now we go ask questions.
We go ask questions.
Do I get to ask you guys questions too?
Sure. Okay. You know what? Sure. Go for it.
Alright, cool.
Alright. You ready?
First. Yeah, I'm ready.
Alright. Chocolate.
City.
Black.
Me.
Love.
Ice.
Beyonce.
Jay-Z.
Champion.
Wale.
Fante.
Animals.
Ninja.
Home.
Scary.
Not me.
That was a warm up.
I can feel it. I feel
that
it.
Was warm up.
Let me take it to the street and relate with back home.
Okay.
Money.
cash. Kudi, my pocket.
Abuja,
money.
Jos,
cold.
Lagos,
heat.
Lekki,
fly.
Runs, girls.
Bad boy.
Thank you.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a
bit. No, it's not been what? I'm going to be
okay, over.
No, I got you.
Oh, yeah, let's go.
Alright, cool. Anything we have, throw it.
What?
You ready?
Yams.
Food.
Belle.
Hunger.
Oh God, I don't have to. I want to catch you like this over. But it's all good though. I'll let you pass.
Thank you so much for being here. Having us.
Thank you, Ice Prince. We appreciate that.
Yes,
thank you very
God
much
bless.
For
big up, man. Afrobeat Live. You know, this is family for me, man. I appreciate you guys having me, man. Shout out to Fam Star. Shout out everybody, man. Thank you so much.
Anytime you come DC, we want you to know this is an open
door.
Anything. Yeah. Now, we want you to give us this guarantee also that anytime Ice Prince have something new to put out there, we'll be a platform.
For sure.
We get it first. We get the scoop first.
For sure.
Okay.
For sure. Now, I promise, for sure.
Secondly, we got to move forward.
Yeah.
You came to Yankee. You came to the state this time.
Yeah.
They said you were holding it down. The other night,
yeah,
you had a wonderful show at Ghana 59.
Yeah.
Big ups to that.
Great.
Shout out to Ghana.
A lot of energy.
Thank you.
You brought it big. You brought the place down. The only artist that represent for Nigeria.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, well, check this out. I happened to be, I was there.
Yeah.
I saw what you do now. Now, check this out. I noticed you didn't come by yourself.
Yes,
You brought a brother?
Yeah, I brought my brother, man.
Okay, you brought a partner?
Yes.
All the way from Nigeria.
A partner in rhyme, my man.
And a bad guy, too. Ladies and gentlemen, I like to call him Mr. 48.
Yes.
Shout out to the big homie India.
You done know.
Welcome.
Bro.
What's good, people?
What's good, my brother? How you doing?
I'm blessed, man.
Over the whole day on Kina Street, we were talking.
Yeah, man.
How's everything going, man?
Blessed.
How was your trip?
It was good.
This your first time out here?
Well, in DC, yeah.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It's really cold, as you can see. I have like sweaters, jackets, everything.
What a fresh man.
And yeah, you know this is my favorite city, right? I always tell you that.
DC.
When I come to the States, DC is the best, yo. For
oh,
real.
Man.
Home.
They say DMV know how to show love.
Yes,
no
doubt.
The love is pure out here.
What's up, India? What you got going on right now?
Well, you know, it's just basically work. Like we have.
You guys are always working.
Yeah,
anytime I tune in online, I see something from the grip music, something from the chocolate shit.
Yeah, we're trying to come up, you know what I mean? Like, just trying to come up and run things proper. You know, but I mean, it's been work. Shout out to Chopsticks, shout out to Young L, family, big up Ice Prince in the area, you know what I mean? And the show was live yesterday, as yo, it was, you know.
It was enough energy, man.
Yeah,
man. It was enough energy. You guys broke.
One thing I was really happy about yesterday was the fact that it was Ghana's independence and Ghanaians thought about having Nigeria crucial love. So, you know, their next door neighbor, they had to celebrate with their neighbor. You feel me? Shout outs to Ghana, man. Shout outs to every Ghanaian on earth. That's love right there.
Yeah.
To share food with your neighbor, that's love.
Yeah. That's what it is, man.
So tell us a little bit about you. What's going on? Who are you?
Okay.
What's going on?
Well, they call me India, but for sure, I'm a dancehall artist. I'm from Nigeria, originally from Benue State. Speaking Doma.
What? You Doma?
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Yeah, so I mean, I have a family I work with. It's called Grip Music. You know what I mean? It's Chopsticks. Chopsticks has produced like big records for Ice Prince, Aboki, to like a host of them.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, there's Young L as well, who's, you know, we work together as a team and, you know, as individual artists as well, you know. So we're pretty much just hustling and trying to come on big time, you know what I mean?
And what's your motivation? Like, what keeps you going? Because it's not easy out here. What keeps you going?
I mean, when I look back to where I'm coming from, man, that's enough motivation for me. You know what I mean? I don't want to go back there. So.
I don't want to go back. Okay, check this out. You had one collabo with Chopstick. Ice was in it also. Was it
Stinky?
Stinky.
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 Let's go.
stinking.
Yeah. That was a mad track.
Yes, I respect that track. Was massive, man. It was big on the streets. It was big in the club. It was a massive one, you know. Shout out to Chuck Sticks.
Hey, yeah. Congratulations on all the successes so far. Like,
appreciate
for real.
It. Thank you.
It's been good. Like, you listen to some artist music and you're like, but then you killed it. I like where it's coming from. I really do.
I really do.
Come on, you're here with Prince. You gotta be the one of the best to be able to do
sure.
with them.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Yeah.
You're gonna be back with us in the studio, right?
Definitely.
Here, right?
Anytime.
All right.
Sure.
And just put myself out there if you guys are looking for any female artists. You know, I'm not there yet,
really?
But I'll work on it.
Oh, you bust some notes?
No, not at all.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we gotta wrap this up. It's been wonderful having these two special guests.
Yes, I.
Big talents. All the way from Nigeria, ladies and gentlemen. We don't want to say bye, we just want to say see you later.
Love.
Big up the Ice Friends, big up the India. You guys show love, man. We appreciate
love.
You guys. Anytime you're in DC, Afrobeat Live, this is the only place to come rock with us, man.
Can I give a shout out real quick?
Give us a big shout out.
I have to shout out my. Can you turn the volume? I can't hear myself too much.
You can't hear yourself?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's do that.
I want to shout out the leaders of the new school, man. My team out here. You know what I mean? They've been working with me for time now, and they've been killing it on everything. The world will soon know what we're up to. Shout outs to Nigel, to OB, Shola, to Uncle Tai. You know what I'm saying? The leaders of the new school were up to a whole lot of stuff, man. God bless. Roger, DV, Robbie Celeste, the whole squad.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here.
If they want to check
Thank
out some
you.
Of your stuff, India, where can we
go to my SoundCloud, India-Music.
Okay.
You can find everything, the latest materials, new stuff. I leave music out there too, so you might be lucky.
Thank you.
Any last word?
Oh, I forgot one person in my shout out. How could that? Lafa. Big homie Lafa.
Yes. Man.
Salute to Big Homie Lafa. Big shout out to Ty's wife. She kissed me.
Yeah, threw it
Listen,
down.
Listen, like, no, I don't want to put her name out there so people don't know who to her house knocking on her door, but she makes the best Nigerian food for me every time I touch down. Her house is always like home for me, man. I appreciate her too.
Yeah.
You know, and to the whole fans, thank you for supporting. I wish my arms are long enough to hug everybody at the same time.
Oh.
God bless.
Amen.
Thanks.
Respect.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap. Ice Friends and Maddie. One time.